Okay, today what we're doing is we're going to be doing an unboxing of our new Aerogarden. It is a smart countertop garden that uses LED grow lights. Now, let's get started. It all comes in one handy dandy box, and when you buy the kit, you will have your instructions, how to register, and some additional information. You will get a seed pod kit, and ours is the gourmet herbs. So it has Genovese basil, Thai basil, chives, thyme, dill, mint, and curly parsley. And we will open that in a moment. And you'll have, this is the rod that holds the LED lamp. Let's get this out of here. There we go, we'll put that there. Boxing material. This is the LED panel that you want to be careful with. We're just going to put this to the side for now while we get the rest of the contents out. Now these are for if you are going to be growing taller plants like tomatoes that would need some support. So it's a trellis system. That. Take this out. So you can just set this aside. You don't need to use it if you're not growing tall growing plants. We're going to be mainly growing herbs this first time, so we're just going to put them aside. Okay, so now is the big unit. There we go. Take this out. There's nothing else in the box. Now this is the base unit. Let's get this off. Of course, all of the packing tape. There we go. So what we've got here is we've got the lid, and this section here actually comes out so that you can put other seeding beds and things like that in, and so that you can clean it. So what happens is You use these little pins to pop out that section, and then you can wash all inside. This is the reservoir that holds the water. You have your fill to line, so you know how full to put it, make it. Your control panel. And at the back, we have two cords. And okay, so we've got one for the wall, and this one is for the lights. This guy here is for the pump, and you have to make sure that that is seated in there or your pump will not work. So let's get this guy in. Okay, so you'll notice it's got a notch there and a hole there, and it should, there, it just snaps into place. These control the height of the rod. Now let's get our LED panel out. And these LED panels are good because they have a much longer lifespan than the fluorescents. Okay, let's turn this puppy around. Nice thing about this is when it does come time to wash the unit, this will pop right out. You just take the pole out and take the basin out. Okay, and then this just sits right there. And the LED light should just go on here. And you hear a little snap. Now you're going to want to put the, let's get this all undone. There we go. This goes into the LED, and you want to be very careful because it actually does not sit flush. So let's turn this around so you can have a look. So you'll notice that there is a bit of a gap here, and you don't want to force it because you can damage the pins in there. So this is actually seated properly. So turn this back around. There we go. Okay, so you see, it's really easy to raise this up. It'll go up, this model will go up 24 inches in total. There we go. And then just make sure that everything is down. So it's quite tall. There we go. Have a good look. Okay, for putting the rest of it together, I'm going to actually bring this back down again. There we go. Well, don't get it in the way of the cord. And this comes down. There we go. And okay, so we're going to raise it up a little bit because we're going to want to put our pods in. Now the instruction manual is really quite detailed. It shows you everything that you need to put it all together. So go through the instructions, make sure you follow them. Now what we're going to do is we're going to get this thing planted and we'll see how easy it is. So, in your seed box, what you're going to get is, for this one, it's a 7-pod one, so we'll have 7 of these. We have 7 toppers that create the sort of greenhouse effect, and we have our plant food. So we'll take these guys out. And in the instructions, it says that you're going to want to put your smaller plants at the front, your taller ones at the back, and your medium ones on the side. So if we look here, we've got the basil, which is tall. So we're going to put it at the back. And we're going to put the dill, which is also tall. I'm going to put the dill here. And the curly parsley, which is short, will go there. The chives, which is short, will go here. And the thyme, which is short, will go here. And the other basil, which is tall. So I've got a basil, a dill, and a basil. And the mint is a medium. Okay, so we've got all that set up now. Okay, so I took the pods out because I actually need to add the water and the nutrients first. So it's going to take 4.1 liters of water or 1.1 gallons. So it takes quite a bit of water. So we're going to feed it through. I just take the top off to feed it. When we top it up, I'll use the little corner access. But for now, for the first go, I'm just going to fill it up this way. Takes quite a bit of water. And you don't want to use well water or softened water because of the it'll interfere with the nutrients. So you want to use tap water or distilled water. That's fine. And I just need a titch more water. Okay, so you just want to fill it up to the fill line. Fill to here, it says. So it's very, very clear. And then we want to put our nutrients in. You need to give this a really, really good shake. And for this size of unit, it says I need 2 capfuls. So there's one. Of course, I spilled a few drops in, so I'll just make it a little bit shy of 2. And then just get all of it in there and give it a little bit of a stir. And then put this away. Now we can put the top back on and make sure it all fits in nicely with the cords. And it just sits there nice and solid. And then we'll put our plants back in. So let's do our basil and our dill and our thyme, which is short, and our mint, which is medium, and our short curly parsley, our other basil, and our chives. There we go. Now we've got it all set. Now these guys here need to go onto the tops, because it creates that little greenhouse effect. It keeps them warm and keeps the humidity in. Once the plants reach the top of the inside of the cap, then you take the caps off, but you don't do it before. Okay, so there we go. It all fits on nicely. And we're gonna wanna bring the light as close as it will come. That can come down. And because they need as much light as possible. The bar seems to be pretty good. There we go. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to move this to where it's going to have its permanent home, and then we're going to plug it in. Okay, so we've got the unit where we want it to be. So what we're going to do is plug it in. And there we go. It's telling you what it is. Now let's have a look. It's saying, welcome to your Aerogarden, press quick plant to start your garden. Okay, so here, quick plant is right here. It guides you through the planting your Aerogarden. Use this whenever you start a new garden. So we press okay. Your Aerogarden clock now shows 12 a.m., which it's not. So we're going to change the time. And it is certainly not in the middle of the night. And if you hold it down, you don't have to click through each of the minutes, which is quite nice. There we go, and we are at 2:29, 2:20, we're closer to 2:20. There we go, and then we press okay. Okay, so now the time is correct, settings confirmed. Select the garden type you're planting. So we're doing an herb garden. Now this says that the lights will be on 17 hours per day. So what we want to do is set the lights on and off times. So now it's telling us to add the nutrients, which we've done. So we say, okay, nutrients are added. It gives you a little tip, always top off with fresh water when adding nutrients. We press OK. Your lights are set to turn on at 8 a.m. and off at 1 a.m. So if that's the way you like it, then great, say okay. If you want to change that, you can. That's it for setting clocks and lights. So it's telling us now to pour the water in, which we've done, add the nutrients, which we've done, put our grow pods in, which we've done, and press OK to start your Aerogarden. Your pump will run in germination mode for a few hours a day. It will shift to run continuously in about 2 weeks. This is really important because a lot of people were thinking that their pumps were broken because they wouldn't hear the pumps. It's not very loud, but you do hear it. So in germination mode, it will not run continuously. So don't think that your pump is busted. Say okay. And this will tell you what the status is. Days planted today, is we're at day zero, and it's saying we're gonna add more nutrients in 14 days. So this is gonna be the status that shows up all the time. Now, the one thing that you may wanna do is, let's see, when you hit okay again, you will get some more options. Now we did the quick plant. If you want to change the settings for your lights, you can go here. If you want to change the setting for your clock, you can go there. Now, this is interesting. You can set audio alerts so that it will tell you when it's going to need more water or need more nutrients. And the alerts will sound every 15 minutes during the times you set. So we're going to say, okay, we're going to turn audio alerts on and set audio alert times, and it'll be every 15 minutes starting at 8 a.m. but they'll stop at 8 p.m. so we're good with that. Settings confirmed, and we'll go back, and you can press home, so it comes back with your status. So what we're going to do is we're going to keep track of this little guy and track the progress of the herbs and provide you with any tips and tricks we learn along the way. If you have one of these units and you've had some good experiences with it and you want to give us some tips or tricks, comment below the video and let us know. We will check back in a few days. Bye for now.